All right, this is Alan Ginter, Dual Box. Thanks, everybody. Good luck. I look up that sheet from TriStar. That sound is, it's them putting it inside the thing.
It's the
vacuum's closing.
Yeah.
Why does it make that screech?
I have no idea. Maybe it's just rusty and they've had the same one since the 90s. I don't know the screech. That's what the question in the area here. The screech. What are we sorting out of this? All the minis, all the weird stuff?
Yeah. You gotta check the backs. See if there's any, you'll notice on there different colors. Well, Tyson, I thought I saw a box here that had your name on it. Texas. Is that good?
It's a variation of it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Apparently that's a variation or something. In stuff. It's a variation or something. I don't know what it is. I really don't. Rob caught it. His eye spied it. We need some autos here or something. Did we get auto yet?
No.
We only got one hit so far. It's three in a box. You guys? Yeah. Reggie's making some brisket. Heather's making some macaroni and cheese, homemade. Can't wait to take a shower, my own shower. My shower is awesome. You also have to look for if the number's missing on it. Like that's 111, but some of them don't have the little card number.
That's something I wasn't checking for.
Yeah.
I'll take you 2 seconds later.
Dakota Hudson. St. Louis. Two hits down, one to go. My scooter's still here. Did someone steal it again this year?
Yeah. I didn't know you fly through the rat tunnels, scooter. I saw your picture. I was like, oh, he's going down the down.
I did that walk enough over the years. It sucks. From the parking garage to here, through the walkway and all that. Forget it. I mean, it's literally 15, 20 minutes to go from your car when you get out to here, just about.
Well, you walk on your feet, and you start at the show, you're like, oh, I'm done. And you're like, oh, no, I have to walk 20 more minutes.
Yeah, it's terrible. They need to put a people mover in there or something.
That's why I paid the extra $5-$10 for valet when it's right here in the convention.
I mean, I know it's wintertime. It's no one wants to walk outside, but. Tyler Kepner is a baseball writer. pretty cool. What if it was signed on card? And he wrote the kid on it. Would that be dope? Doesn't even look like Bryce.
What?
Doesn't really even look like Bryce. Weird.
Probably made it just to get in the set. Looks like created it.
Poop holes.
Tell you off there, but me and Josh Hamilton had a 3 minute conversation, 3 or 4 minute convo about Bryce, and it wasn't complimentary. That way.
Thank you for remembering. Any of those ginters he signed at the booth come up on eBay yet? Special ones?
Oh, I haven't seen it.
I guess not, because I don't know what he kept them. Look at that, Dawson.
Did you know that the old Top Shelf Breaks card?
Do you have Yerkes' number?
Yeah, I do.
Should text him and tell him his card's on eBay.
I just do Facebook messaging.
Yeah.
He always responds with that, like,
a him and I go on these rants. He's very gun pro-gun. And
I heard I'm a lot not. Of bad stuff happened this weekend, and I don't even know about that.
Yeah, I know.
Back-to-back mass shootings all over here. You gotta do something. I don't know what. I can't give you an answer.
Well, I would think about stop selling high-powered weapons.
I'm okay with that.
I mean,
I'm a gun owner and I like my guns.
Yeah.
I don't need an AK-47.
No.
I don't need some of these things that they email me about constantly.
Yeah.
Just being honest.
I know, dude. There's enough. I mean,
how many more people need to die? It's common sense.
The thing
it's
I was.
It's a political issue.
The thing I tell him is, it's like, if there's a little malfunction on a kid's freaking Disney toy. That a kid got hurt on and a kid died. One, the world stops and they change everything, recalls, you know, become social media viral, but yet we sell guns in stores that are high-powered weapons of mass destruction and nothing changes. It doesn't make sense. there was a washer and dryer that was electrocuting people. By accident, every time you tried to take out your laundry, they would stop making those, recall everything, yet they sell it for 40 cents. I don't understand. And I want someone to explain that to me.
So I gave 47 in my email. They go, hey, special this week.
Really?
$1,900 or whatever. And I'll look at the thing. I'll look at my dad and I go,
wow.
Can I buy these?
We are no longer selling these washer and dryers as they're dangerous. Somebody could get hurt because they were wired incorrectly. Let's stop the presses, let the world know we're not selling these. Meanwhile, who wants to buy AK-47s? The logic. And so him and I go back and forth in a healthy debate. My uncle's a gun collector. He collects like old school cool ass pistols and stuff. Very ornate handles and stuff like that. Well, you can see the chat. Are we still live? Or did the feed get knocked off?
Hey, Jeff. The first thing that happened when I got my YouTube. Yep, here
I was. I was waving, did you see it? I'm gonna do this gold standard, and then that might be it for the day, unless I'm missing something. I can tell you this, if you think you had fun buying spots at the National, wait till I get home and get some rest and refresh and re-energize and spend a few hours on the website building some new brakes and a blitz mix. Those two boxes of ginter were a bus. Oh, he's hugging his aunt. Oh, was my mic on for the gun conversation? I'm not trying to spark a debate. I was just talking to Rob.